tonight, the Avs round out the quick two-game homestand as they welcome in the Anaheim Ducks.
Bounces, but not out of the zone. Andrew Ghetto put it behind the net for Rantanen to take. Reverses, trying to get away from Fowler. Shuffled it back to the point. Nemeth teed it up and a shot with MacKinnon screening.
Gibson is an interesting guy, Mike. When you're watching Gibson for the Anaheim Ducks, he is huge. He plays the game. He is a number one goaltender. And when he's on, he's a game stealer. The problem that he's had, Mike, is staying healthy.
Flip pass to the point for Barry. Sends it across the rink for Rantanen. Side of the net. For Landeskog. Andrew Ghetto at the half boards. Avs on the power play. They had three shots in their first power play opportunity, but we are in a scoreless first period. Shot score! Power play goal! A tip in front, and the Avalanche have a 1-0 lead on their third power play goal of the season.
Landeskog does this real well. Mike, this is a quick twirl. He just twirls in front and throws it far side. He practices that all the time because you got to get it on the far side of the pad. Great job. He extends the arms and the hand. You know you're going to get popped down low. But this group, like we saw it last game, really moved the puck well.
We have 4 minutes left to go in the period. Nieto streaking up the ice, dropped it back. Soderberg with a shot in the chest. Rebound chance. Another chance. Another save by Gibson. Scramble for the puck. Hands have got it. Back to Como. Slides it across. Shot to the far side point by Bigron. Missed the net. To the point for Barbario. He shoots, and that went off. Defenseman Montour goes wide. And carried up ice by Perry. Chased down by Duchesne. Picked his pocket. Duchesne out hustled him and grabbed the puck. Brought it back in. Give it to Barry. Nice move to cut down the slide. Great pass. Back in. Saved by Gibson. His old teammate bumped him. He fell back into the net but kept the puck out.
The word around the hockey world was let's wait and see. Let's wait and see how he responds to, you know, the brief press conference that he had, all the swirling controversy. Was he or was he not going to report to camp? And he's been terrific for the Avalanche.
That's a new goaltender,
right?
Rento Barrett. Puck brought in down the wing by Como. Shot save, rebound! No goal! Been waved off. The puck went in, but it has been waved off. Did they crash the net too hard and into the goaltender?
That's what he's saying. Now here's Como driving. Mike, it looks fine right to that point. But he is in the blue. And Barrett is turned a little bit to his right, but boy. I mean, this really is whichever side of the coin you're on sort of thing. If you're with the Avalanche, I mean, he's trying to avoid any contact. It's not like he is purposely driving through Reto Vera. And Nieto comes in behind and just does a nice job picking up the rebound. But he does, he turns that right shoulder, squares him up so he can't follow through the puck. But here's the one that they seem to be looking at right here. See, he hit the blue. There's no question about it. But he seemed to be making every effort to not run into there. Now, is that going to help, hurt, whatever the Avalanche situation? Okay, this is a key moment in this game.
Here we go.
After the coach challenge reviewed, there was goaltender interference. Therefore, the call on the ice is confirmed. Hold on the play.
Wrap around in front, and the puck squirts free, racing up the ice. And a quick pass ahead for Duchesne. Dropped it. Andrew Ghetto with a shot. Save. Rebound chance by Andrew Ghetto, and that's blocked. Andrew Ghetto's on a three-game point streak right now, along with Mikko Rantanen.
Usually by this time of the game, 24 minutes into the game, you've got an idea of what you're looking at as far as how the teams are playing. I got to tell you, I got no idea. The game is not shown, you know, what kind of game it's going to be. Is it going to be hard hitting? It doesn't seem to be overly hard hitting. Are there going to be a great offensive plays? Not really to this point.
Eric Johnson pushed ahead for Wilson, crossed the red line, sends it over the line for Landeskog. He shoots, save made by Vera, and he falls forward and covers the rebound. Avalanche carried the puck in, cutting to the front of the net, centering try in front by Yakupov, denied. There's a penalty coming up on the Ducks. Delay call. Bernier to the bench. Duchesne with the puck. Dragged down by Beauchemin. Puck still alive. Nope. Touched by the Ducks. Whistle's been blown. From the point, shot by Manson. Deflected. Here's an opportunity to get one. He shoots. Saved by Bear. Followed up. Shot blocked in front by Manson, but a bounce.
Two things going on here. Andrew Ghetto trusts that Rantanen is going to find it because, Mike, you're just disappearing out of the zone full steam, and Rantanen just, Mike, right on the tape.
Into the Anaheim zone. Gets checked by Boschman. Pinned him up against the board. The puck came free. Duck steal it away. Pass out to center. Cogliano coming in for the trailer. Montour shoots and scores. Through a screen. A shorthanded goal.
Well, for the Avalanche, Mike, how reminiscent is this of the goal in New Jersey? The defenseman jumps up into the play. There's three guys that are caught up ice that don't get back before he gets into the shooting area. And all of a sudden, we're looking at a 1-1 hockey game. Power play goal for the Colorado Avalanche. Shorthanded goal for Anaheim.
Handoff made for Barry. Skates in. Back towards the point. Copper shoots. It's good, but no! It may not count.
There's no goal on the play as a Colorado player makes the goal against here.
And so twice now, the fans here who are booing have seen what they thought was a goal by the Avalanche taken away because of goaltender interference. Cross ice off the skate of Andrew Getter. He's got a man up the ice. It's Rantanen. Got a cut in. That's a circle of the net. Through the front. Rantanen for the Avalanche on the power play. Right back from Andrew Ghetto. Rantanen. One timer by Barry. That will count. And the Avalanche get a power play goal and have a 2-1 lead. What a blistering shot by Tyson Barry. The Avalanche with their second power play goal of the game. 10 seconds to go. Ballard shot through bodies, bouncing around in front of the net, cleared up and out. It's on. It's headed toward the empty net, and it is. Yeah, it counts. That counts. That's an empty net goal for the Avs. Their fifth of the season. It made it with a half second left to go. Fifth empty netter seals the game for Colorado. They're going to win both their home games.
They didn't do it once last year. They did not win three games in a row once. And now they've won three in a row. They weren't three games over 500, as we mentioned, not at any time last year. And now they're three games over 500. They're 2-0 at home. They have dominated the Bruins at home. They've dominated Anaheim. Final shots here tonight are going to be 39-18. All they could talk about was, are they going to be better defensively?
The game is over, and Jonathan Bernier gets his former team. Gets the victory. He's now 1-1. And Tyson Barry with the game-winning goal coming on the power play in the third period. The game winner tonight for the Avalanche. And Coach Bednar said, when you're facing your former team, Peter, you want your teammates to really play even extra hard for you to get that victory. They certainly did tonight.